In our industry, we all strive every day to be the best that we can be, to touch lives, to have an impact, to make a difference. And most of us are happy to do that without any expectation of recognition. But the best and most important recognition that we can receive is that from our peers, those who have been there, done that, and understand like no one else can what we have truly accomplished. To help us recognize our 2018 Hall of Fame inductee, please welcome back Hall of Fame Committee Chair and Managing Director of Rotterdam Festivals in the Netherlands, Johan Moorman, and 2018 IFEA World Board Chair, Jeff Curtis.
One more award to go, and an important one. It is a real pleasure for me to recognize the IFEA Hall of Fame inductee of this year. The Hall of Fame is the highest honor that an individual can get in the festivals and events industry. It is a statement to their career, to their achievement, but most importantly, a tribute to the life they touch. The IFEA emphasizes our core values of excellence, sharing, and community. Every IFEA Hall of Fame inductee, past and present, has understood those values and exemplified them in every aspect of their lives. Please join me now as we get to know more about our 2018 IFEA Hall of Fame inductee.
One of the most globally connected and influential professionals in the festival and events industry today, Bill O'Toole's unusual career path could be titled The Accidental Tourist. With events nowhere on his radar, Bill graduated with a pure mathematics degree in 1972 from the University of Sydney. He could see clearly his future as an accountant or statistician and, as a result, wisely decided to pursue music. While at the University of Sydney, Bill used his still undefined event skills to organize treks for his fellow students through the Australian bush while also forming numerous bands to play for campus dances. With music in his blood, he moved to England in 1977 to attend the London Guildhall University and learn the art of instrument making, where he formed the dance band Loza Bella. Looking for how to stand out from the crowd, literally, Bill reinvented the English bagpipe and put the band on stilts, a walking stage. Loza Bella performed successfully at numerous fairs and festivals around England. Bill proudly points out that the band is still growing strong, touring Europe and celebrating its 40th anniversary in 2018, having now released over 14 albums. In the early 1980s, Bill moved back to Australia, where he met his future wife, Ruth, and started a family. Not veering far from his now musical roots, Bill formed the band Sirocco and toured the world, including some 30 countries, laying the foundations for his fascination with international cultures. During that time, he served not only as performer, playing the tin whistle or whatever was needed at the time, but as band management, logistics planner, tech roadie and merchandise sales manager. Marketing a unique style and genre that were unusual in most musical circles, Bill started creating and producing their own gigs, concerts, and events to ensure employment. His first official acknowledgement of events becoming a recognized focus in his career. His signature event was a concert in the wetlands of Australia, a 9-hour drive from the closest city, broadcast live to Asia and the Pacific from the middle of a swamp in the outback. The broadcast, CD, and video of that event helped the local farmer save over 900 square miles of wetlands and bird habitats and brought attention to the problems of water supply in Australia. The power of events was now clear to Bill. Expanding upon his now growing skill set, in 1987 he formed a performing arts agency called the Larrikin Booking Agency, and started pitching event and festival concepts to shopping malls, Main Street associations, government departments, and the corporate world. He constantly looked for new opportunities and created work instead of waiting for it to come to him, developing a broad range of world music festivals, children's festivals, jazz festivals, magic festivals, and several arts and heritage festivals. His constant search for new event opportunities and his love of travel led to some unusual gigs in places such as Papua New Guinea, Vladivostok, Borneo, Urumqi in Western China, Nepal, Northern India, and a Salute to Australia festival in Houston, Texas. When his band Sirocco arrived in Houston, their equipment had mistakenly gone to Hawaii. So at their first gig, Bill thought to ask the audience to help find musical instruments the band could use. The audience scattered, and with half an hour, all they needed and more arrived on stage. In the jungle of central Borneo, Bill worked with the local Dayaks to create an event for the local mining company. The miners in these regions were being murdered by the locals, and Bill suggested that a celebration in music and dance may help establish a new friendship between the locals and the company. He was right, and recognized again the power of events to change people for the positive. Bill likes to point out that, interestingly, and perhaps reflective of his career path, almost all of the places he toured were hidden by the binding in his old school atlas, hidden gems in the most unexpected places. In an effort to organize the exponentially increasing chaos in his life, Bill began learning the skills of project management and wrote his own software programs to meet his organizational needs. In 1996, he attended a course in event management at the University of Technology, Sydney. It was the first year of the course, and they needed a person with direct event experience. Bill fit the bill, and he started the teaching and training part of his career. In 1999, Bill returned to his alma mater at the University of Sydney and created a series of event management courses online as part of a Master's in Project Management program. Simultaneously, he gained his own Master's of Engineering in Project Management with a thesis on the application of project management as it relates to the delivery of events and festivals. As a result, he co-authored one of the global industry's first event textbooks, Festival and Special Events Management, adapting project management, logistics, and risk management to the production of events and festivals. Recognizing an increasing need to professionalize the now expanding and growing global festivals and events industry, Bill struck upon the idea of developing an event management body of knowledge, EMBOK, to collect and classify the knowledge and skills needed to create and manage events of all genres. In 2000, he wrote a paper on the topic that was taken up by Julia Rutherford Silvers, an educator with the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, and Janet Landy with the Institute of Event Management in South Africa, and now the president of IFEA Africa. Janet organized a number of professional conferences on the EMBOK project in South Africa. The EMBOK was codified by Rutherford Silvers and taken up by the Canadian government, the South African government, and the worldwide conference industry. It is being tested today by IFEA Africa and the South African government through the Skills Village 2030 project for broader release by the IFEA and other professional, government, and educational institutions in the future. While all this was going on, Bill made time to travel to his first IFEA convention in Anaheim, California in 2003, where he met with the leadership of many top U.S. and other global festivals and events. This interaction inspired him to assist in establishing IFEA event training programs around the world. Bill's second textbook on event project management, released in 2001, catapulted him further overseas to consult with organizations and governments in the development of their events and the training of their event teams. He started in Dubai in the United Arab Emirates, working with the government's tourism and marketing department to develop and build the potential for festivals and events as part of their 2020 World Expo vision. This created a center in Dubai for people to come from all over Africa, Europe, and the Middle East for training in events, project, and risk management. Private companies such as Jack Morton, Deloitte, Hewlett-Packard, and thousands more sent their staff for training. In all the many countries where he has worked, Bill emphasized the need for their events and festival teams and government organizations to link to the IFEA. This resulted in the delivery of the IFEA CFEE Professional Certification Program in Dubai in 2011 for the Dubai government and to the IFEA's involvement in the Middle East Event Awards and other regional training programs. Bill helped open the doors and advise on the provision of event conferences and/or professional training in many countries, with direct participation by IFEA leadership at many of those. Bill's career then took him to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for a long-term project to explore and develop the potential of events in that country. At the same time, his previous efforts were resulting in recognition by the European Commission and the United Nations of the power of events to efficiently and effectively heal countries after war, while also assisting in their economic and social development. In partnership, they sent Bill to parts of the world he hadn't yet worked in, including Liberia on the west coast of Africa, Sudan, Uganda, and Jordan. His global industry awareness and influence were continuing to grow. Bill's work in Saudi Arabia started in 2004 and culminated with a nationwide tourism event strategy, which became part of the exciting and dynamic opening and development of Saudi Arabian festivals and events that we are witnessing today, and which the IFEA is playing a central training role in. This work on event strategies resulted in his third textbook, Events Feasibility, From Strategy to Operations. His books have now been translated into 5 languages and provide the foundation for university and professional training courses around the world. Since 2013, Bill has been a pivotal member of the teaching team for the IFEA NRPA Event Management School at Ogle Bay National Training Center in West Virginia, where he oversees and directs the second year Event City Challenge experience and has worked closely with IFEA President and CEO Steve Schmader to create the new CFEA designation as a pathway to the full CFEE professional certification. For the past few years, Bill has limited his traveling primarily to working in Paris, France, and the United States, allowing him time to revisit and rework the National Handbook for the Australian Government on Crowded Places, and to co-author and edit an all-new textbook on crowd management, security, risk, and health. Bill has served actively on the IFEA World Board of Directors, the IFEA President's Council, and the IFEA Global Roundtable, and continues to serve as one of the industry's top global advisors and conduits as we look to the future. Please help us welcome and congratulate our 2018 IFEA Hall of Fame inductee, William O'Toole.
That was quite an epic. I actually just went from one gig to another rather than a plan. Look, I'd really like to thank Steve, who's both a friend and a colleague, and of course the board and the staff and volunteers of the IFEA for this award. I think it's the first award I've ever got, and it's certainly the most important in our industry. There's no doubt about that. Although I go around the world, I'm going to make this short. Although I go around the world teaching and training in various sports, in various events, particularly training in risk, project management, asset management, and all the hard stuff, I actually, when I go home, I run a little street party every year, We have about 30 kids in our street, and I'll just tell you one very quick story, because, well, it's a good one, that's why. Each year I try to get the whole street together. It's really easy to do, actually. It's because everyone wants to do it, you see. But the trick is to have something for the kids to do. You know, the parents are, you know, they will just get into the booze and chat. But you've got to have something for the kids. So one year, we just had one three weeks ago. But the year before that, we had a thing called the Book Bash, where all the parents and kids brought out their books so we could swap them in the street. We decided to have a competition with the kids, you know, something to do. And so we told them to read a passage from their favourite book. And this would be a competition. We found the local politician came along, so we found a use for her to judge. You know how they turn up. To give them something to do, to judge the book reading competition. Anyway, so the kids got up one after another. It was fabulous, you know, and they applauded. And finally, this little girl got up, and she took out the book. You know, only tiny, she's about four or five, took out the book, and with her fingers, she went through the words. You know, after about a minute, she shut the book and then looked up and waited for the applause. It was then we realised that we didn't say read out loud. And for the last year, people in our street have been coming up and saying that that was the magic moment. That was the special moment at that event. And that's what you people do. You create that special moment. It doesn't have to be the razzmatazz. It doesn't have to be the fireworks. It could be something as simple as a shared magic moment. And although I do all those other things, the support structure and all the rest of it, ultimately, it gets down to something like that. So I really appreciate the award actually comes from all of you. All of you that enrich our lives through those magic moments. So thank you.
Congratulations again to Bill O'Toole. Very, very, very well deserved. I can speak personally to the amazing career that Bill has had, and I feel very honored to be a very, very small part of some of the things he's accomplished in our industry. You've set an example for us to aspire to, Bill, and we are going to do our best to learn those valuable lessons and carry them home. And obviously, you all know from today that I know how to read aloud.